Thank you for joining us. I'm Laura McHugh. In this episode, we begin a new series. We'll devote the first week of each month to the local art scene. In fact, we've brought a piece of that art scene into our studio with hand-blown glass made at the Banana Factory in South Bethlehem. That's where we start the show with Focus reporter Brittany Garzillo.
Thank you, Laura. From vases and bowls to decorative pumpkins, these artists handcraft molten glass into one-of-a-kind works of art right before your eyes. The artists you're about to meet make glass blowing look easy, but as I quickly learned, it's both difficult and rewarding.
Talent, teamwork, 2,000 degree heat. The glass blowing artists at the Banana Factory in South Bethlehem turn up the heat on traditional art as they mold molten glass into masterpieces.
To me, it's an art that's almost like a sport. So the molten glass is actually located inside the crucible.
Artist and glass studio manager Dennis Gardner retrieves what he calls a gather of glass from the 2100 degree furnace and quickly cools down the metal rod before shaping his next piece. Dennis says glass blowing requires both artistic ability and an ounce of athleticism.
But not only is it hot and physically demanding, it's a lot of time on your feet all day, a lot of movement, moving around. So it's kind of like you're active, you're exercising the whole time.
John Choi, artist and creative director of the glass studio, uses tools to effortlessly etch each detail, a skill he's perfected for the past 20 years.
You and the fire and your skill and natural ability and your glass knowledge from your teachers, that's all you have.
Together, both John and Dennis have handcrafted thousands of pieces, from functional bowls and flower sculptures to a 40-foot tall glass sculpture located in Arts Quest.
Transforming molten liquid into a tangible object, to me that's really powerful and very exciting.
According to John and Dennis, the art of glass blowing dates back more than 2,000 years. John demonstrates how glass blowing got its name as he blows into the hollow rod, creating a bubble in the glass. With every turn, the bubble grows bigger and bigger and bigger.
Practice getting the glass out, shaping or blowing or certain tooling. We practice those little steps for years. And believe it or not, some of those moves might take you your lifetime.
Both Dennis and John share their expertise with other aspiring artists in classes offered through the Banana Factory. Some students continue with glass as studio volunteers.
The glass is your teacher, so you need to watch how it's moving in order to take the next step and make what you want to.
Everybody does the same thing differently, so it's up to you to find your way. So that's the beauty of it, because there's no right and there's no wrong. It's what you want to make of it.
According to Arts Quest, the glass studio opened in 2006 and is the only hot glass studio in the Lehigh Valley.
The learning curve is rather steep. And when you see somebody who's blowing glass and they know what they're doing, it looks very easy. So many students come in and they see you make something and they're like, oh, that looks pretty easy. I think I can try it. And just pulling the glass out of the furnace is challenging if you've never done it before.
Up for the challenge, I accepted John's offer to try it myself.
Want to do a pumpkin?
Right, here's one of my favorite tools. We call this the bonker stick.
The bonker
yep,
stick?
Yep, so you want to grab that? Excellent. Now, in just 1 second, I want you to tap this part of the stick away from us, okay? Doesn't need to be a home run. We just need a base hit right here, okay? And make sure you hit it away from us, okay? Go for it. Perfect. Very nice.
And one of the things about glass blowing is you want to make something that's nice in a team of people. It's very challenging to do by yourself.
And now we're going to put this stem right on top here. Just make sure it contacts all around the piece. And now this glass is nice and hot and molten. So this glass is about 2,000 degrees that we're making the stem out of. And your pumpkin is still very hot, still probably 1,000 degrees, but it's stable. And then the last thing we're going to do is we're going to wrap this around our wooden jig here, and then we're gonna put it on your pumpkin.
If the glass were to stay out and cool in the air, it would crack and break. That's why once a piece is completed, it's put in an annealing oven.
A few days later, my glass pumpkin is ready for display.
You can learn from me, but you're not gonna blow glass exactly like I do. So you really have to develop your own relationship with the glass, and I think that's a really unique thing with the material.
It's like so much fun. It's like figuring out the puzzle that's been around 2,000 years, and that really excites me.
Whether you're a seasoned pro or just starting out,
woo.
Both Dennis and John agree that glass blowing can ignite the artist in all of us. For Focus, I'm Brittany Garzillo reporting.